Hi, in today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up and use Dubsado Scheduler. So right now I'm in Dubsado. I'm in the scheduler here on the left-hand side. And you can see that I have some appointments already set up here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a template. So this is how you would create like a new type of appointment. So all I'm going to do is use like sample appointment. You can set here how long you want it to be. These are like the standard times, and you can add like your own. Let's say you want it to be, I don't know, 20 minutes, something like that. And when can this be scheduled? So rolling day window means that depending on what day they're looking at your scheduler, it's always going to be like 30 days ahead from that day. You can set it like 30, 60 days ahead, so that it's always moving forward. You can set a fixed date range. So that works well, like if you have a specific event on a specific date, like up to that date, you can set it, or indefinitely. I personally use rolling day window. I don't like to give people like an indefinite view of my calendar because I just don't know what things are gonna be like for me. So I just put a rolling day window of about 30 days because you don't wanna give people, depending on what your appointment type is, you don't want to give them the opportunity to book too far ahead. You want to keep that appointment closer, especially if it's like a sales call, a discovery call. You want it to happen sooner rather than later because you don't want them to kind of like forget about the appointment. And when are you available? You can go in here and change, like if you want your schedule to be 9 to noon on Fridays, let's say, because you take the afternoons off, you're just going to do 12 p.m. here, add time. Actually, I have to remove that one. Sorry, add time. Oops. Let's go here, 9 a.m. to noon. Okay, all Fridays, let's say. So you can see that if I go ahead, it's showing 9 to noon on Fridays. And you can do that for all the days of the week. You can, let's say there's a holiday one day. You want to, or there's a specific day, you know, you're not going to be available. You want to take that out. You can do that here. Granted, if your Dubsado calendar is synced to whatever calendar you're using, like if you're using a Google calendar to manage your scheduling. So I personally use Google Calendar. I have all my personal and my business appointments all in there. So let's say it's a holiday. I have it blocked off in Google, so it will show off. It will show as busy in Dubsado as well. So if you're managing your calendar through, you know, Google or whatever calendar you're using, and you're syncing that to Dubsado, you don't have to worry too much about this. This is more about setting like your work hours. Location. If it's a physical location, you can put that in here. You can add video conferencing. That just means that if you look up here in these settings, this gearbox, you have to have Zoom integrated and it will automatically send them a Zoom link. Down here is if you're sending the email, someone asks you and they say, I would like to book an appointment with you. You can send them this email with a link to your scheduler so that they click on it and then it'll open a browser tab with your Dubsado calendar with this specific scheduler, right? So that's one way to kind of like share your scheduler link with someone. So these are the basic settings. If you go to advanced, prevent bookings less than X hours in advance. So personally, I have this set at 24 hours. For some things, it's set at 12. I like to be prepared. So I don't like having someone book, like, you know, I get a notification that says you have an appointment 30 minutes from now. That kind of doesn't work for me. So just set whatever buffer that you need here to feel comfortable in having, like, how soon would you be comfortable having a meeting, and set that number in hours in this spot? Is it 4? Like if someone books a call with you 4 hours from now, would that be okay with you? That's the number that you're gonna put here. A buffer time is basically how many minutes before and after each meeting that is booked through the scheduler do you need to kind of think of it as prepping for the call and like writing down, jotting down notes, or like if after a call you always have to send them like a proposal or something like that, give yourself time to do the stuff you have to do before the call and after the call, that's what you would build in here. So let's say you need 30 minutes before and 30 minutes after so that you don't have back-to-back calls. And it allows you also some breathing room. So display available time and increments of, so when you look at the scheduler, do you want it to show as 9, 9:30, 10, 10:30? That's what they would see as available time. Like let's say you have a block from 9 to noon, that's free. If you have it in 30-minute intervals, they're going to see 9, 9:30, 10, 10:30, 11, 11:30. So whatever you want, do you want that to be 60 minutes? Do you want them to see 9, 10, 11? Or do you want them to see the increments in 30 minutes? So that's what you would set over here. Allow a maximum number of appointments per day. That's self-explanatory. I have that set like at 2. I'm sales calls, specifically sales calls. I know myself enough to know that after like 2, I'm kind of burnt out. I'm a massive introvert, so I set that at 2. Like strategy calls, because those are longer and pretty intensive, I think I have those set at 1, just because I want to be able to serve my clients as best I can. So I have a strategy call set at 1 per day. And allow the scheduler to be used X number of times. That works. Let's say your scheduler, it's like a promo, and you say 10 free consults for, you know, the first 10 people who sign up. That's what you would put 10 over here to kind of limit how many people can sign up for that specific scheduler. So here, this is what they see at the top of the page. We'll look at this. Welcome. I'll just put so we can look at it later. Confirmation email. So this is the email that they're going to receive that shares with them like it confirms that the appointment is booked, and it tells them like where, when, all this sort of details. So pull from your canned emails. Dubsado has a bunch already in there, so you can use those. I'm just gonna let me see. Let's just say that new form. So for instance, in my case, for my discovery call, it's attached to a lead capture form. So you can attach this to whatever form you need. So I'll just do that. So what URL do you have, like a thank you URL, so that when they book, it takes them directly there? Or do you just want to use the default confirmation page? I just leave it at the default. It's up to you. It's like, this isn't going to make or break anything really. It's just, if you have a thank you page already created, you can might as well just link it here. Additional options, invoice. So let's say this promo that you have here that you want to use 10 times is a paid appointment. You can add it here. So here you just have to put kind of like what it is, what's the pricing, all that sort of thing, right? So it's kind of like creating an invoice. It is basically creating an invoice over here. So you just say what it is, the description, the quantity, the price, tax if applicable, all those sort of things that you do with invoicing in Dubsado. Notification. You want that. You do want that. You want to make sure that whoever is coming remembers. So what I do is I generally set a notification 24 hours before their appointment. So let's see, do I have like a reminder? There we go. Add. And then I do it like an hour or 30 minutes ahead of time. You can do 30 minutes here. And I'm just picking something that's, yeah. Monthly view. So I will show you what that looks like. Let me just save this. So this is what the appointment scheduler would look like. Let me go back to the advanced settings. So you can see that I have it in increments of 60 minutes, hence the 10, 11, 12, 1, 2. It's not showing me 10, 10:30, 11, 11:30, right? And the form, this is my discovery call form, my inquiry form for those who want to sign up for a discovery call. So it's attaching that to the scheduler, right? So let me go here and turn this off to show you what it looks like without the monthly view. I don't like this one that we're going to see right now. I don't know what it is about this particular view, but I don't like it. I think my brain is just used to seeing the month, right? So this kind of like scrolling bar messes with my brain at least. So I'm not a big fan of it, but this is an option. So yeah, this is how you would use the Dubsado scheduler. If you want to embed your scheduler into your website, let's go to my website for a second. So in my website, you can see that I have my discovery call embedded in here, right? So how did I do that? I have a YouTube video. You can look at the link. I'm just going to put it up there on how you would embed a form or a scheduler into your website. In my case, it's specifically for Squarespace, but the idea or the steps really of how you do this apply to other builders regardless of what platform you're using. So I hope you found that helpful. If you have any questions about using a Dubsado scheduler, feel free to write them in the comments below. And if you need help with Dubsado, you need help with your setup, or you just have workflows that need to be tweaked and improved, or you need help with form design, feel free to reach out. You can see my link below to book a discovery call, and then we can talk about where you need help and how I can help you. Take care. Bye.